Having the ability to send out agreements and manage e-signatures has become essential in today's business world. And near the top of that list is DocuSign, perhaps the best-known website and application for e-signatures. However, depending on the size of your team and your needs, DocuSign can get quite pricey. Let's take a quick look at their pricing page. Now, their personal plan starts at just $10 a month, which sounds quite reasonable. However, that limits you to just 5 documents a month. So in most cases, if you're sending out more than 5 a month, you're going to have to upgrade to their standard edition, which starts at $25 per month. And yes, that is per user. And with all of the other subscriptions that you probably are engaged with, that can add up really fast. Well, this is precisely where a tool like DigiSigner comes into play, offering you the same features and security of DocuSign, but at a fraction of the cost. So yes, you can get started with DigiSigner with their free plan. Now it's true, that's only going to limit you to 3 documents per month, but perhaps you're only sending out a small number of agreements. If you need to upgrade to Pro, it starts at just $12 per month. Yes, that's less than half the cost of DocuSign's standard package. And if you need to add more members to your team, you can subscribe for just $40 a month, which includes up to 5 senders. In contrast, just 2 standard members here within DocuSign will cost you more than up to 5 senders here within the team plan. So, enough about pricing, let's dive into DigiSigner and show you some of the features and functionality. So here I am within my DigiSigner account. And first off, I love the simplicity. DigiSigner is not trying to lure me in with a variety of different options or folders or links that are probably not necessary. Because when it comes to documents and agreements, I want to come in here, I want to upload, I want to send it, I want to see what is waiting either for me to sign or I'm waiting for others to sign, and then get on with my day. I'm not running my entire business here within a document signing application, but it's important, right, to secure those agreements and to secure those contracts. So everything is very easy and well laid out. Now, let's get started by uploading a document. And you can upload almost anything. It doesn't have to be a PDF. In this case, I'm going to come down here to a sample contract form, and I'm going to upload this particular document. So here it is at the top. Now, I haven't sent it out just yet. Again, DigiSigner keeps it simple. We either can sign it ourselves, send it for signing, or we can have other more options, which I think is great to be tucked away. More on this create link a little later, a feature which you will pay a bundle for within DocuSign. So after uploading your document, the first thing you're going to want to do is specify where you're going to want others to either fill in information or where to sign their name. So in this document, I've got a few different fields that I'm going to want to specify. And the great thing is of course, I can create a template out of this. So I only have to do this once and then repurpose it in the future. So at the beginning of this document, we've got a date field. So I'm going to come over here and select that date field. So it's very easy to input there. And then I've got some client information. So probably, yeah, a text field is going to make the most sense. Now, you'll notice when I click on any of these fields, I have some other options available to me here on the right. So instead of just saying text, I can actually help them along and say client name, for example. Then that will appear directly within this field. Let's stick with a text field. We're going to put that down here for address, and then we'll do for phone as well. And of course, everything is essentially drag and drop. So if we want to line that up, we can do so. But let's go down to the signature part itself. So here I'm going to add a signature field, and everything can be customized, right, to the space or the document that you have filled in here. I want them to next input their name. So let's do that down below, and maybe I'll give them a little more space here. In this field here, so it matches up with the signature line. The date field, in this case, I'm going to choose the date signed, because why have them fill it in when we just want to take whatever date it is when they actually sign this document? Make it easier for them and also ourselves. And last but not least, I'm going to put in one other text field here. Let's reduce the size of this just a little bit like that. Perfect. All I need to do at this stage is select done, and now this document is saved and it's ready to to be sent. So in this step, I'm going to say send for signing. So here, some of the nice features within DigiSigner is that just like in DocuSign, we can set a signing order. So all of those more advanced features that you may be used to in other tools, you can do right here as well. So if I'm going to be sending this out to multiple signers, I can say in what order it needs to take place. So after filling in an email address, let's fill in this email address here. I can check some of the other things, including what the message will look like down below. I'm going to say send the document. And immediately I have a status of that document down below. I can see that it's been sent to this email address, but it hasn't yet been opened. In this agreement down below, you can see number one, it has been signed by this individual here. And just for my example, I use the same email address. It was also viewed, so I can see the status of when someone has viewed it or not. The great thing is I don't have to dive into any special folder or any special waiting area. In fact, if I want to resend the document or just remove the signer, I can do that all here as well. So the layout, the simplicity of it allows me to be more productive and efficient so I can get on with my day. Now, when it comes to those who are receiving your documents, the experience is simple and straightforward. So here I've received a notification that someone has sent me the document. I'm going to select open the document, which will pop it open in a new tab. And if you've signed anything in the last few years, you will notice what this experience looks like. I can add my own branding. So here you can see they can be confident that it is coming from me. I'm going to agree to use these electronic records and signatures, which makes this signature binding in this case. So now you can see I've got all these fields here waiting for me. I'm not going to fill them all out. I'm just going to jump down to the signature one here and I'm going to say, yes, that's my signature. Or I could draw it or I could upload a signature. In this case, I'm going to use one of the pre-filled ones. It's going to remind me that, hey, you haven't actually come up here and signed or filled in the client space. I can hit next as it will walk me through the different sections, give me sort of a gentle reminder as to where I am in this document. And if we jump back into our DigiSigner account, I can now see that that document has been viewed. I can keep tabs on this just in case I don't receive that signature within a desired time frame. Now, another great feature within DigiSigner is the ability to create a link for any of your most used documents. So let's say, for example, you're offering an agreement on your website, or maybe it's something that you just send out so frequently, you don't need to pre-fill it with their name or their information. Wouldn't it be easier just to get them to click on a particular link? So in order to create a link, all you need to do is select the More dropdown and then select Create a Link. Now, the first thing it's going to do is create a template. Now, here you can see I've got the URL. So this is the link that I can either embed in my website, I can add within an email, or wherever I would like them to access it. And I can set a few prerequisites, such as what I want them or need them to do before signing or after signing. In this case, I'm just going to keep it nice and simple and hit save. Now I can jump down to the templates section of my account, and here I have that agreement waiting for me. I can click on the More button and say Show Link and copy this and send it to whomever I like, saving me time, but also saving many of my users or my potential customers time if I want to give them access to an open document, allowing them to sign it and fill in their information and then send it at their leisure. And of course, all documents signed with DigiSigner are legally binding, and they comply with all major e-signature laws, including e-sign, UETA, and the European Union. So if you'd like a simple and professional way to manage all of your e-signatures and do it at a fraction of the cost, be sure to check out DigiSigner. See the link in the description for further details. Now, if you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy the videos which are being recommended to you on the screen now. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.